Where are my skirt pieces? We tore these, we folded and pressed back week one, wasn't it? Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you guys have already done that pressing. So now we're just marking them. Okay, so I have put on the board the basic information that you need. So you can see how I have it laid out here. Front, back, the fold is underneath and they're facing each other, okay? You're going to come down and mark your hip depth plus 5/8 of an inch and square across, okay? Got that? Mm-hmm. You're gonna take your back hip arc, mark it, come out 1/4 inch. You can see I put that there, hip arc. Hip arc, HA is hip arc plus 1/4. And that way we know where that is. Let's do the same thing on the front. What's your front hip depth plus 5/8, square out, and then have the hip arc there. Okay, hip arc, but it's the same as that. Front hip arc plus 1/4 inch, okay? Last thing, your book says to measure in 2 inches and mark X. It never works. This is the way I come up with it, and it works, okay? So you take your waist arc, this is for your X, you take your waist arc plus ease plus dart intake. Below here, I have front dart intake, back dart intake, and both of them will have 1/8 inch ease. Okay, so you're going to do a little math. Front waist arc plus 1/8 inch plus 5/16 twice because you got 2 darts, so it's plus 5/8. I did it like this so that you could see, oh, dart 1, dart 2 equals 1 inch. Dart 1, dart 2 equals 5/8, right? Okay, so waist arc plus 1/8 inch ease plus dart intake total. Whatever that is, you measure out from center, make a line, make an X, do the same thing on this one, and we're ready to drape. So you can see I have mine ready to go. Here it is. Here's my front, here's my back. I have them just like they were on the board. Hip depth, and of course I did 1 1/4 extra because I'm full scale, squared out. Hip arc plus 1/2 inch ease, hip arc plus 1/2 inch ease. And then I'm going to draw my side seam in from top to bottom here, so I can actually use my ruler if it's pretty straight. Just keep it straight and draw that in. We can do it without it too. I forgot to do it in the morning class and it turned out just fine, but why not do it if we can do it? So we'll draw that all the way down. So from the hip down, it's a perfect rectangle, okay? And I've got my X marked on this one. I still need to do it on this one. So let's see. My front waist arc is 7 3/8. For me, I need 2/8 in ease. And then my 2 darts added together are 1 1/4, but I changed it to ace, so it's 1 2/8. So 7 3/8 plus 2/8 plus 1 2/8 equals 8 7/8. So from the fold, excuse my fingers, a little yellow. I ate something with turmeric in it. 8 7/8. You know how that marks up your hands?
Yeah.
It's a little embarrassing, but okay. So from this end out, 8 7/8. Let's do it where I can actually reach it. Okay, so 8 7/8. I'm going to draw a line and label it X. Okay, and there you go. I've got both of mine ready to go. And as soon as you have all of this marked, and I want to see clear, crisp, beautiful lines. Last time I was seeing some fuzzy lines, so please make sure you've got crisp, beautiful lines. And I'm going to take that off. So as soon as we get that done, we placed the hip depth level. So it's at the bottom of the hip tape. We're going to put a pin in like that, so it's at the bottom. Then we're going to come to the waist and put in a pin. I'll stop. See, it's hard for me too. And then at the bottom here. Okay, as soon as I've got that, then I'm going to pin the hip. Make sure that stays at the bottom of the hip tape. I'm going to pin the hip arc here so it matches. I'm going to bring the X up to the side waist and pin that, and I'm ready to drape. So something like that, okay? All ready to go. All right, so get that marked. Let's do it quick.